tell me where the cash at. I've been on the fast track. Shorty want my heart, but I can never.
Guys, welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be upgrading my Isopod habitat. So as you guys already know, we have my Isopod habitat here. And this colony has just taken off. Watch when I lift this wood a lot. You can see all the isopods in there, but watch how much isopods are on the bottom. If my camera would focus, you can see there's at least 100 in here, and there's tons of babies. They just had new babies, as you can see these tiny little babies down there. Therefore, we're gonna be upgrading the isopod colony, cause an upgrade's always cool. So my dad, kindly shout out to my dad, gave me this container. So first thing I'm gonna wanna do is I'm going to wanna put the lid back on this container for now. And I'm going to wash out this container, and then we will get into today's video. But if you're new to this channel and you're not already, I have a lot of pets and I do videos about my pets, so consider subscribing. And comment below how you found this video. I find it really cool, whether it's through notifications, whether it's through YouTube search. I just find that really cool to see how people are finding my video. Also, sorry for my hair. If I keep going like this, it's because it gets in my eyes. But yeah, so I'm going to go wash out this container and get back to you guys. We washed the container out nice and good. You could either decorate it right now or do this next step. Okay, guys, so now is the fun part, decorating. So you can see we drilled a ton of air holes. If this is not enough and if you start seeing black mold poking up, well then I will fix that. But right now what we're going to do is start decorating. I'm super duper excited for this. So first thing I'm going to do is we're going to get some leaf litter in here. So we have a ton of pieces of cork bark. I'll show you some in just a minute. You can see tons of cork bark in here, little pieces that we're going to work with. But first you're just going to want to dump in your substrate. I'm just using some leaf litter in this situation. Just gonna use a bit of leaf litter. You want a decent amount, so where your isopods, you know, can go through it and stuff. I'm just using leaf litter. You can always incorporate other things, like you can always incorporate some substrate, which is what I'm doing that now. But I'm just using a ton of leaf litter. And that's enough, because remember, you have some substrate in here. Now it's time to dump in your isopods. Again, I'm not done setting up yet, but kind of have to because I need some of the substrate. So for now, since tons of isopods are in here, I can't really get them all out. This has to go in here. So yeah, I just put that in there. Now we're going to dump their substrate in. I'm just going to take this out, actually. Hope the isopods just don't run away. But just gonna dump the substrate in now. And you wanna try to get all the substrate out, because just remember, substrate has eggs sometimes. Or I don't know if they give live birth, but substrates can have like babies and eggs and stuff. So you just try to get all the substrate out. And now I'm just gonna mix it up. And I think that looks pretty nice for some isopod substrate. Now, we got our little house right here, but I don't want to put this in here right now, so we're just gonna decorate with some little pieces of cork bark. So I kind of like this one, guys, because I don't know if you guys can see, it has like cave in there, so it's kind of like a little cave because it caves in. So they can, like, you can see they have that little opening to go hide under there. And then I'm going to incorporate, this piece is really cool, guys, because it has like that cave aspect to it too. So maybe something like that. I think that's pretty cool because they can hide like all in there, all under there. And then we're going to put their big piece over there, something like this. And then, oh, this piece is really cool. So you just want to definitely like just litter with cork bark or really any wood, because that's what it would be like if you think about it in the wild. We got this little piece here. By the way, I got all these pieces from breaking a big cork flat up. So I got still tons of little pieces left. So I think this is a pretty cool enclosure. Now, let's see if some of the isopods will start exploring it. Let's, you guys can see them all in this wood. Let's see if they'll start exploring their new home. but they'll eventually come out. You can see there's tons of babies in there. There's like 25 babies up in this place. So let's just start seeing if they'll go explore the new home. Some of them are starting to come out. Go explore your new home, guys. They're just disappearing right into the leaf litter. Some are actually exploring, like I saw a few. Oh, there's one right here. Can you kind of see them? Forgot I can't zoom on this camera. So, not gonna have the best footage because my camera's half broken, but under here, you can see them all. Right, there's one. You can see a baby crawling. But, oh wait, there's one right here. Some of them are definitely exploring this new bin. And the good thing is this allows them to expand their culture more, which is great. So this old bin, I'm just gonna probably do something else with the old bin. But the last thing you definitely wanna do with your Isopod, oh, you can see one. A new leaf litter. You can see a few. My shadow was out of the way. And see some in the leaf litter. Right in there. There's like one or two. See if I can get them out for you guys. But also these leaves act as great hiding spots, like this big magnolia leaf right there. This is like a really natural enclosure and I think it's really cool. Oh no, we have a fallen isopod. There's a dead one in here. But the last thing, like I was saying, you're going to want to do is you're going to want to mist it. So I'm going to grab my mister and get back to you guys. I missed them. The tank, you can see an isopod that is exploring. Right there, just gone into the leaf litter. You can see them in there under the leaf litter. So now we're just going to come up our mister and get them a nice mist. Oh, you can see one coming out to explore on top of his house. I don't know if you guys can still see him. It's right there. Some people said they like the isopod content. That's why I'm filming this. So yeah, we're just gonna mist down their enclosure just a bit. Just so the substrate can be nice and moist. Sorry if you don't like that word, but they like high humidity so they can shed their exoskeletons. So yeah, just mist down the substrate a bit. And now the next thing I'm gonna wanna do is feed them. They will also eat the leaf litter. So I'm going to grab, oh, you can see isopods are, oh, one's coming out. Go explore your new home, buddy. Oh, there's another one. Yeah, so like I said, I'm going to grab some food for them, leave it in here, and then I'll get back to you guys like when I see them eating the food. So it's been about an hour since I put a couple carrots in there, but before we end off today's video, you guys are going to watch some B-roll while I talk about a little bit just about isopods, just in case I'm going to talk about some simple facts. So as you guys can see in the B-roll right now, I'm just showing you guys the isopods crawling around on my phone because I can actually zoom on my phone because my camera's broken. But I just want to say some cool things about isopods. Isopods are actually closer related to lobsters than they are insects. They are crustaceans, believe it or not, which is actually really cool. The isopods I have, because I know I'm going to get this question, I actually got outside. I took two and then let them captive breed, and now it's been like 6 months. Now they're all captive bred. I did this for a lot. So, yeah. And you can see they are coming out, crawling around, and exploring. So I'm just gonna, yeah, I think that's really cool. Now that you're back to my face cam, I think that's super cool how they're most likely related to lobsters than they are insects. You can kind of see it. I'll put in the close-up footage right here, but you can kind of see, like, the close-up. They kind of do look like lobsters. So I think that is really cool. But also, yeah. So if you guys did enjoy today's video, let me know in the comment section below. Drop a like, smash that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you on the next one. Make sure to do your research, comment down below some video ideas. Yes, you sitting right there about waiting for this video to end. Comment down a video idea right now. Thank you guys, and I'll see you on the next one. Do your research. I'm out. Peace.